Okay, so what I want to do tonight is just help everybody get their week four assignment done. So if you could type in the chat what you need help with, then go ahead, everybody who's here, if you could type in the chat what you are wanting to get help with, that'd be helpful.
You've already helped me with what I needed help with.
Okay.
So now I'm just here to help you, I guess.
Are you a helpful person, Chris?
No. I'm just being nice.
I think you are a helpful person.
Trust me. The previous design school I was at, I was not helpful to anyone. And it's not because I couldn't do anything. I understood it and picked it up very quickly. It's just I wasn't willing to help anyone who was very rude. And a lot of people were very rude.
Well, just my opinion, my take on you is that you're very helpful.
Thank you.
All right, so Frances is trying to share a screen, and she says, now I cannot get to work at all. Liz, are you giving up? Okay. Oh, no, I think, okay, good. Oh, okay. I'll be right back. Let's see. Okay. All right. Go ahead and show us.
I hope this is right. Do we go here or do we go here? That's what.
No, stop at the frame. Yeah, the top one.
Yeah, it wouldn't work. All I go, it's not letting me have it. And I don't know why.
I literally just got done watching the video for it.
And see, it does that, but when I go up here, that little A or whatever, it's not there.
That's, you know what, that's, that actually was what I had encountered when I tried to add the action script. That, one second.
Okay. Why is the tree there, though?
All right. Let's see.
Messed up the whole thing. I'm going to have to start all over.
Wait a minute. Let's.
This is right here. It's supposed to stop right here. But when it gets here, it's got the tree and the birds. It's not supposed to have that or even the panel on there. So I don't know what happened.
Do you want to delete? Do you want it to stop at frame 120?
Just for the, that's the animation.
Okay. And do you want anything to happen after frame 120?
Yes.
What would you like to happen? Oh, it's your ending.
Yeah, it's my ending, but this should not be here and all these birds.
All right. Why don't you go ahead and let's try your animation.
Hold on. Just hello.
I'm going to mute you, Chris.
Okay. Thank you. Sorry, I was in class.
No worries. All right.
Mrs. Burr.
All right. While she's typing, I'm going to read your chat, or while she's talking, I'm going to read what you guys wrote. Joshua needs help stopping the audio. Yeah, we were having trouble with that the other day. Now I can't get to. Okay. And Stephanie said, I need help with the moving my file down, and also how do I bring in the first page with my words on it? Okay.
Got a lot going on, so.
Oh, it looks like, I'm going to mute her. Okay, so Joshua, why don't you share your screen? Let's see what we can do about stopping the audio.
I can help with this one.
Great. I knew you could. Yeah, Chris, you're very helpful.
Like I was telling you.
All right.
Go ahead and help him, Chris.
Okay, click on your audio file.
Right.
Now go to properties. Are you working with the original FLA, if I'm not mistaken?
I'm not sure.
Yeah, this is an FLA file.
Yeah, it is.
That's strange. It was able to come up on mine easily.
Well, I'll show you what happens when I export it to a SWF file.
Okay.
And it'll repeat once, and then the audio will stop after that. And it should stop right here, but then the audio keeps going. And that's what comes up when I tried that, click to stop.
Okay, let's hold on 1 second. Hold on. Let me look at that.
Okay.
All right, so that is saying security error. It song one load click to play stop sound. Now this is interesting because you're did you implement the one where you click so the sound stops?
That's the one that I tried. Yeah.
Yeah, and then you and this happens when you click. Am I right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Also, the weird thing is too, I had exported over to an MOV file, and when I initially played it, I didn't have any sound, so I actually had to drag my MP3 into the video on Quick Player, and it now is able to save it that way.
Interesting. The MOV export did not include the audio track.
Yeah, I didn't. It included the sound effects, but not the MP3.
Oh, I wonder if...
Is it in the library?
I wonder if that's an issue of licensing or something like that. That's kind of interesting that the sound effects are there, but maybe it's the MP3 file format. What's the file format of your sound effects?
They're all MP3, I believe.
Can you move the width of your library over so we can kind of see the rest of the file name? Oh, actually, the line between up there, the list name and linkage. So there's a bar right next to the linkage on the left, right there. Grab that and push it. Yeah, they're all MP3s. Wow. Yeah. All right, you can recollapse that how it was. I just wanted to kind of see. So it's not a question of the file format, that the audio file format. All right, let's get back to this. Right now, the problem we're trying to solve is stopping the audio from playing. And I think you want to stop it on frame 294. Is that correct?
About 294,
295. 295, okay. All right. Now, Chris, you had a Chris called me up the other day and said, hey, there's this great method for ending the audio track. Chris, why don't you describe again how it worked for you? In fact, if you want, for a second, we can have you share your screen.
Okay.
Show us what option you use to truncate the audio.
What I did was simply, and I did this in the native Flash Player 16 ActionScript 3.0, like nothing changed. It was the native file, and I would click on it, and right here in effect, I would just click on the pencil, and I could change up the length however I wanted.
Okay.
And it would change here.
All right. So let's see. The drop down on the name, the sound. Do that drop down again right there.
Right here?
Yeah. Let's look at – okay, so it's MP3. Let's see.
Yeah, this is MP3.
Okay, so, and you're selected on a frame. Let's go back to the property type that you showed us a second ago. Just click right there. And yeah, let's look at that. Say target Flash Player 16. That's the version of the Flash Player that you're targeting for this. 3.0. And so now let's go back and click on the audio. I wonder if it's because you have that frame selected and that, or that the layer selected, and that might make the difference here for somebody else to do that same thing. So let's do that. Why don't you stop sharing your screen? And Josh, can you share yours again? Thank you very much, Chris.
How do I stop?
Okay.
I don't see the... the little
Chris, Josh, all you need to do is go ahead and share your screen, and then that'll take control over it.
Okay.
Ah.
It says I can't do it. I have to wait until they're. It should be up on the top of the. Yeah, it won't let me share it.
Let's see, I wonder if I have. Okay, I just start sharing. I mean, I started sharing.
Yeah.
I'm going to stop sharing mine. Okay, give it a try now, Josh.
Okay.
Sorry about that.
It's all right. Yeah, I probably have a hard time stop sharing my screen, too.
Okay.
Now, let's go over and, okay, you've got that layer selected. Just for the heck of it, why don't you click off the stage? See if the effect is grayed out. Change your publish settings up there. And let's see. Okay, so you've got HTML, JavaScript.
Oh, that's what it is. She's working in a... In the converted file.
Oh, am I?
I worked in the original.
So that might be the variable here that he's working in an ActionScript based file, and you're working it with a Canvas HTML5 Canvas default. Upper left where it says profile, can you click on that drop down upper left right there? Okay. Now click the right the gear right next to it. Let's see. Import profile, export profile. I'm wondering if the variable here is because you're working with an HTML5 canvas.
Yeah, it happened to me before when I tried to do it, and I couldn't quite do it well, and I was unknowingly working in a converted file.
Well, we got two different types here. When you start off, I think the assignment two in week two had everybody start off with HTML5 canvas, and I think you may have jumped to the ActionScript version or something like that, but that might be the variable here that the reason why he can't do the editing is because he doesn't have an ActionScript 3.0 based project file, and you do. That might be the variable that would allow you to do it, because the Flash runtime can do different things that can't be done in the HTML5 JavaScript, and there's pros and cons to each. And so why don't you click cancel for a second here, and down at the bottom, click cancel, and go up to the very top, do file, let's see, file, and then do save as. I want to see if it gives us the option to save it out. Okay, so that's the file format is Flash. But does it let us change it to a let us change it to a different to the action script?
It might.
I don't see that they're giving us the option to save it out as the action script based project file.
Yeah, I just continued working with what we had in week two. So I didn't really start any things. I remember week two was, the HTML.
Yeah, file. Yep. I think that's the variable here that's making it so that Chris can do it in his, and, I can, Jack, what I'll do really quickly, what I'll do is I'll show you that. Let me share my screen.
Okay.
And let's see. File, new. Okay, Josh, what do you think I would type right here if I wanted to do the standard, not the HTML5 version, but the standard one? Which one would I click?
That'd be the ActionScript 3.0, right?
That's right. So this is, I think, what Chris did.
Yeah, I always go to ActionScript. I've always worked in it when I've went to Flash before.
Okay, yeah, I was just following the directions on the...
Oh, there were directions? Well, then. Didn't follow those to key.
No one's judging you, Chris.
Thank goodness. My previous teachers would have gotten mad.
It's going for 1 second. Okay, what's the deal here? The air whoosh, maybe it's just I need a longer one.
See, Steph, I'm just a horrible reader, so.
No one's judging you.
You're better than me if you saw it, though.
Don't worry. No one's judging. We're not judging him. We're not judging you.
Don't worry. I don't feel judged.
Good.
It's difficult for me to feel judged.
In week two in the directions, because I created a new Adobe Flash document using the HTML5 canvas. But like I said, just kind of weird that,
Why aren't, what, now I'm having a hard time just getting the audio track on there. No, it's there. I hear it now. Okay. It's kind of hard to hear. let me try and see if I can get one more here. Import to stage. See if I can get one longer, or maybe a little louder.
Thank you, Steph.
Well, there's a long
Yeah, there it goes.
You can see it takes a while for it to start up. All right. Okay. Lydell just got here. We're working on different ways to stop the audio, and we're
awesome, Miss Lindell.
We're finding we had to see what the differences were on the between Chris, you can just click on the audio track, go to properties, and right here he can change the ability for, see, did you give it a instance name or a class?
No.
All right.
It was up under sound.
Published. Okay, I'm on the, let's see. Frame.
There we go.
Okay, I don't know what I had clicked on. Okay, the effect. All right.
That little pencil.
And so if you have a Flash ActionScript file, then you'll have the ability to edit your soundtrack directly and shorten it. Now this thing's pretty long because it's like a whole song. So, but that's the variable here. I was really excited when Chris called and said, hey, you know, this is a cool way, but it's only if you have, if you started off your assignment with this one in week two, then you can do this. But the instructions, I'm not judging anybody. It's kind of the first time we're doing this curriculum, so I'm not holding everybody accountable for exactly what it said. But this one had everybody start with this. So if you do that, and
I only got ahead of myself.
And if you do that, and then you import the music, then when you drag that out,
again, thank you, Steph.
All right. I don't know if that dragged, I don't know if I got that out there. I don't think it's there. There we go. Can't hear it.
I would not turn that all the way up. It is going to boom.
Oh, I can hear it this time. All right. So this is the HTML5 canvas one, and
it was really low. I thought it was the Sage one.
So here we can't edit it. So the HTML canvas project file does not allow us to edit the effect like the other one allows us to edit it. This is an ActionScript 3.0 project file, and it allows us to do the edit of that audio track, like this, edit the envelope. But the other one, see, you can see the word canvas right there. That's the indicator that this particular project file was created HTML5 and canvas, whereas this one was done with the regular. So, okay. Okay, I'm going to mute you, Chris. All right. So, okay. So right now we want to get back to, now we understand why Chris can't do what, I don't know. We now understand why Josh can't do what Chris did, because Josh created his from HTML5. And so let's go back to Josh. And Josh, would you share your screen? I'm going to stop sharing. And let's go back and see if we can.
Give me 1 second. I think I might have stumbled onto something, but I want to test it before I show.
All right, that's fine. Okay, while we're waiting for Josh, Liz, were you ready to share your screen? yet. Sure. Did you like start over on your audio track or what? Okay. All right. Well, let's see where you're at. Okay. All right. So the good news is, well, all right. Anyway, go ahead. And are we working on stopping the audio, or what are we working on? I can unmute you.
Stop.
Okay.
But I don't know if I need to bring every one of these frames over to where I stopped. This bottom frame stops at like 180, or around 180. But when I get here, it's blank.
Yeah.
Blank. So I don't know why that's blank.
All right. So let's first find out what kind of, I think you've got a, I think the kind of file you have is,
it's FLA.
Yeah. Both of them are FLA, both the HTML5 canvas as well as the Adobe Flash. They both are FLAs. Now we need to figure out exactly which of the two you have, whether it's the canvas. Now, it doesn't have the word canvas in parentheses, which makes me think that you may have an ActionScript one. So there's a couple ways that we can figure out exactly which of these you have. One, why don't you click off the stage? And then click properties. Let's see. Which one? Oh, yeah. Okay. See that? ActionScript 3.0. So that means that this should work for inserting an ActionScript. Now, let's go back and click on the frame where you want to stop. And let's add a new layer, call it Actions Layer. Add a new layer, call it Action. You can actually call it whatever you want, but let's call it Actions. And let's see. Yeah, let's go ahead and right there, click on Window. Yeah, you're doing great. Keep going.
Do I go to Actions or Timeline?
Do Timeline Navigation. Let's stop.
And I do this one right here, correct?
Yeah. Double click, yeah. Okay. Now,
now it's working again.
What's working?
It's got the little A up here now.
Oh, good. That's what I was hoping on. Okay.
Well, I'll play it, see what it does?
Well, yeah, I'll save it because it's a good thing. All right, go for it. Now, I'm not guaranteeing the audio to stop, but let's at least...
I'm not worried about the audio. I'm just trying to let it get it stop at the end.
By the way, I played around with yours. This looks great. That's awesome. I love it. I love it. I hope you're proud of it, because I would be. Did it work? Did it stop?
It looked like it did.
Yeah, I think you got it down.
The blank is okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Nothing there.
Yeah, let's see.
It didn't work a while ago, and now it works. I don't understand that.
This looks great. That was awesome. By the way,
I'm done.
If you want to, you know what? I actually am not requiring people to stop the audio. That wasn't really one of the requirements. The only requirement was to stop the animation. So, so let's do this. Let's see. This is great, by the way. Can you go at your look at your camel for a second? Because I played around with yours, and I
know it's a little pain.
Oh yeah, I got your. I moved your camel at the midpoint. Yeah, just double click on your camel. I love this, by the way. I really did. Double click on him. See, got unlocked.
Sorry, it's locked. It won't let me change.
All right.
Okay, there we go.
Okay, great. Now, let's just go step two, click on like frame 10 or so. And right there. Now, I recommend that you just make his this mid thing here just a little more pronounced, a slightly bigger step. And you know how to do that, right?
You just move it forward or backwards. See, that's where I'm confused.
Just hinge it. Pretend like his shoulder is a hinge, and it actually is. You got that perfect. That's perfect. Now, okay, grab that and then move it to the left a little bit because I think his to the left and hinge it. There we go. There we go. Something like that, okay? Now let's click on the other three legs and do a little bit more. Yeah, move him back just a little bit because see, that's the back one. Go back. You're doing great. It's perfect what you're doing. Okay, and then, right, do the front one. Move him forward just a little bit. I love this animation, Liz. I really, really, really liked
watching. Move this one back a little bit?
Yep. That's right.
Come on. Oops. Maybe that'll work. And I can do his tail too, right?
Oh, yeah.
Here.
Definitely. Okay, by the way, I needed to correct myself from a couple days ago. There was a context for me saying the following. I led you guys to believe that within the context of an FLA file, that the timelines, that the object's timeline is a different, remember how I used the analogy of the spaceship, you know, it's like the different timeline. Now, it dawned on me that was actually a concept that is for the next class where we create our own movie clips that have their own timeline. But if it's just, by the way, is this symbol a movie clip symbol or is it a graphic? I don't remember what kind you have. What kind is this guy? We can actually look in the library and see what the camel is. Which one
is the legs?
What? Those are the individual legs.
Yeah, there's no, the neck and body's here.
All right, let's go back. Click on scene one. And now, okay, so that thing that's selected, the character. When you click on him, okay, oh, that's the animation of the character. I'm trying to figure out if it's a movie clip. Click on properties, upper left, if you would.
It's a graphic.
Graphic symbol. Okay. I think the context of what I said is that if it were a movie clip symbol, it would have its own timeline and its own frame. But when it's a graphic, then it has to cater to the scene one. So it kind of is in the same warp, if you will. So anyways, next class, we will do animations that live in their own, they have their own timeline. We'll be...
It'll be a while before I have another class like that.
Are you in the bachelor's program?
Yes, but I have history next time.
Okay.
Yeah,
Hold on to this animation because...
I'll save everything.
Okay, good. By the way, I actually hope you... I personally... hope that you include this in your online portfolio. So we have a lot of classes where we work on online portfolios, and I'm sure hoping that this one makes it there. That's actually extra credit for this week. So anyways, I still need to show you ways of adding your file to an online website. And so
yeah, I have a portfolio, but it's in Google.
It is, eh?
Yeah, that's something I created a long time ago.
All right, well, we need to find out whether or not Google will let us upload a Swift file, number one. If not, then we can see. I think that we can just maybe export this into, do an export and create HTML and JavaScript file. And maybe, I don't know what Google's rights will give you to be
able to. I have no idea.
Yeah. There's two, the Wix, I know Wix will let us upload Swift files, SWF files, and add them in.
I've been working on Wix, but I haven't got it finished.
Okay.
So that's
one option. And then the other option is having our own website on a web server. because the other APP 242 and DES 241 classes teach you how to create your own personal portfolio website. Anyways, now what I'd like you to do is go to the beginning, and if you would, and then run the animation again. I see you. I think you slowed it down, which is good. I actually slowed down.
Do I need to slow it down more?
Well, let's look at it now, because I think I slowed it down to like 5 frames per second.
Okay.
I love that, the background graphic that you can do. Let's see. It didn't seem like those legs were moving like I thought they were. Let's go back to that camel and let's step through that animation and make sure that those legs are moving like we had thought. You can just double click, clear the Swift file here, and then double click on your camel. Okay. Scrub over to frame 10. Yeah.
See, it's moving, but it's still too fast. See, it went to 4 and then it went to 10 real quick.
Okay, do it again. Jump to the beginning. Oh, all right, good. That looks like a good movement.
But it's really slow. I think it's really fast.
You know what? Oh, I see. All right, so this is... Maybe what we should do is work on both end boundaries, like frame 1, the position of frame 1, and the position of frame 20. So go ahead and click on, we can either...
decide which one?
Yeah, either one. So let's, okay. Because what we need to realize is it's going to make, frankly, a camel, if you think of the full stroke, let's see. It would go from forward, so frame 1 would be a very much a forward, and the other one would be very much a backward. Now, doesn't a camel, I'm trying to think how it walks, like when the front left goes forward, does the back left go forward at the same time, or is it the back right that goes forward?
I have no idea. I don't know about that one.
All right. Well, I think the front left and the back right are supposed to be, we should watch a video of a real, because I think that the front left will be way forward and then the front back right will be also way forward. Give me a second while I do a little research here on animation. I'm going to search for camel videos. Figure this out. Click on videos. Walking camel. I need a walking camel video. The camel walk. Okay, that's exactly the YouTube I need to watch. All right, so front left. Oh, it looks like the front left. It's interesting. Interesting walk. The back left goes forward, and the moment that the back left hits its forward position, the front left is in its backward position.
So we need to reverse it.
Yeah, let me say that one more time so that I can figure out what I just said. But the back left needs to come forward in its full forward position. And when it's done that, the front left will be in its full backward position. And there's a slight delay, but the back left takes off at the moment that the back left hits then the back left or the front left takes off and does its full motion. So what you can do is decide what frame one should be. Frame one could be where the back left is in its full forward position.
You're talking about back left. Are you talking about the outer right, this one?
Oh, is that what outer right is? Yeah.
I have outer left, outer right, inner left, inner right.
Oh, okay. I see.
Mine's a little different.
Yeah, you're using his reference to our eyes. I was thinking of in reference to his body. So, yeah. Outer right. Yeah, put that one in its full forward position.
I think it's already in the forward. Like okay, right there.
It's got to be so far forward. If you watch the video, it's got to be so far forward that it's really close to the – it should be like midway underneath the hump, about right there. And then take the outer left and move it back.
This one?
No, that's the
– oh, this one.
Yeah, and move it back till it's right about where the –
oh, I did something wrong. Hold on. You can stretch it by accident.
Command Z. Yeah. There you go. Move. I don't think you're selected on the one that I thought you were selected on.
This was you mean out.
It's the other one, the one that's closest to us.
This one.
Yeah, that's the one.
Yeah, go backwards.
Back.
Come on.
Yeah, there you go. That's good. It's yeah, something like that. So that's one position. Now, the other two should be in the opposite. And so the other one should be on the right, should be on its full back position.
This one?
Uh-huh.
Should be back here?
Yeah. And then and then the other one has to be in its full forward position. Okay.
I might have made it a little bit.
Better. Yeah, that's perfect right there. Okay, now let's go halfway to frame 10. And now these need to be in their opposite of the position they were just in. So
this one goes backwards.
Yes.
About right there, probably. Let me see. And then this one goes backwards, correct? Or should I do this one first? This one goes forward. This looks kind of funny. Let's see. This one goes forward. And the next one goes backwards. Okay. Oops. Yeah. Am I wrong?
I don't know. I don't think that's it. I actually think because that one you just turned.
I think I reversed it.
Yeah. Why don't you undo that?
One more. Oops. There. Yeah. Okay. So this one should go.
It should be forward.
Okay. I thought I had it forward.
Okay. Maybe you did. Now lock that. And now let's go grab the other two legs.
This one?
Is that the other one?
I think so.
It should be back. Oh, wait a minute. That's not.
See, that's what I'm getting confused about.
Here, once you undo that and then turn off, not only lock it, but also turn off the eye. Click the eye on that layer. Lock it and do the eye thing both.
That one.
Yeah. I want you to lock it too. Just so that we're good. Okay, good. Okay, now let's grab that other leg.
Which one? This one or this one?
The left one. There. That one. No. Okay. That one.
I'm trying. It's being stubborn. Oh, it's locked.
Oh, now I'm confused. I thought we were locking the other one.
Oh, it's locked right down here, I think. Hold on. There you go. There.
By the way, you can make your timeline a little bit larger there if you want. Drag it down.
What do you mean,
timeline? Up there where you have all the layers, that whole area, go down. No, just make the, no, be careful now. I just want you to just expand the timeline area so that there's more layers showing.
You're talking about this.
Yeah, right. There we go. Okay.
Yeah. That's all I'm showing.
Okay.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
All right, good job. Okay.
So do I need to, do you want me to start all over on this?
No. Let's see. I think you're on the right track. Now this leg here, isn't that his right leg front? Or are we
placing it on his left?
Pardon me?
If the camel is facing you, it'll be his left.
Oh, okay. Well, we've already animated him at this position. We want to animate his other leg, his other front leg.
So let me make that one disappear. There you go. And unlock it. Okay, got it.
So is that his right front leg?
Yes.
Okay, great. Now, in the midpoint, it should be back to its backmost position. Okay, good. And now, if you want, you can lock that if you want. Yeah, if you want. Yeah. I mean, we're going to be bringing them back. The only reason I had you disappear before is because we were having trouble selecting it. So.
Hey, that looks kind of cute.
Looks like an ostrich now. Okay. So now, is his right rear leg in its right rear leg, his right rear leg?
This one?
Yeah. Is that all the way forward? Why don't you reveal the other, yeah. Okay, let's see. I'm getting a little bit confused.
Don't feel bad, I'm already confused. I was gonna see what it looked like. See, it's not sort of, but forward is too far, I think. So I don't know, I'm confused.
All right, well, let's keep going. Let's click on frame 10, scrub to frame 10.
Is the camel walking or running?
Just a walk.
Yeah, it's supposed to walk, and it's not doing a good job.
Looks like Josh has his thing figured out. Good, Josh. Hold on one sec. Okay. So frame 10, go back one frame. You can actually hit a comma and it'll take it back if you want. Okay. So his at this point, his right front needs to be back. And his right front needs to be in the back position, and his right rear needs to be in the forward position.
Are you talking about this one right here? Why is it not working? Oh.
His.
Hold on. This one or the one on the other side of it? I'm confused now.
All right, let me talk it through. Let me just say it out loud what I think we need, okay? Let me just try to describe it to you verbally. In frame one, on the left side of his body, his left front. Now, we're not using relative to our eyes. Pretend like you're the camel. In frame one, your left front leg needs to connect about going back, needs to be in its backmost position, and in other words, pointing in the back of the body, and your left rear leg needs to be in its most forward position. So let me say that again. In frame one, if you're the camel, your left leg, front left leg, would be in its backmost position, and your left rear leg would be in its most forward position.
So this should be back.
And let me go on.
Okay.
Midway through. Wait a minute. I just described the left side. The right side will be the exact opposite, meaning your right front leg will be in the most forward position in frame one. And your right, it's the exact opposite of the left leg at that point. And the right rear leg would be in its most back position in frame one. Now, halfway through your animation on frame 10, each one will be the opposite of what it was in frame one. Then at frame 10, each one will be back where it was in frame one. All right, now, I didn't describe that really well, but I would like you to try to describe it to me if you would.
Okay, see, that's why it's confusing, because I have outer and inner, and you're saying left leg, right leg, back, right leg.
Yeah, if you want, I can redo what I just said. If you want, I can use your words. Let me try doing it again, describing again what I think we need to do using your words. Now, outer left, outer right, inner left, inner right. Now, when you say outer left, is that left relative to us?
This is right here.
Okay. Outer left. Okay.
Yeah, it is.
And then which one's outer right? That one. Okay. All right. Let me try to describe it how I described it. Now I'm going to use the words that you're using. In frame one, which is going to be the same as frame 10, frame one, we're going to have outer left to be in its most back position. And we're going to have outer right to be in its most forward position in frame one. And I think you might have that. Now, the inner left and inner right will be the exact opposite.
I was just checking to see if he's was on, and he is. And I don't know if he's going to stay on. I'm just...
I think that was Brandon. Yeah, it was. Hold on, Brandon. Okay, so back to where we were. Outer left and outer right. Outer left needs to be in the most back. Outer right needs to be its most forward.
Okay.
Now, the other legs, the inner left and the inner right need to be the opposites, meaning the inner left needs to be all the way forward, and the inner right needs to be all the way backward in frame one and frame 10. Then halfway through your animation, they will be the opposite extremes of what they were in frames one and 10, meaning what was all the way back is now all the way forward for each of them. And what was all the way forward will be all the way back in frame 10, because that's your midpoint. And okay, the full pace, the walk of your camel, will be going from one position to the opposite extreme halfway through, and then back to the original position. And so frames 1 and 10 should be identical. Your camel ought to look at the same place that it was, because frames 1 and 10 will be the same. It's the frames 1 and 20, I apologize. Frames 1, the very first frame and the very last frame will be the same. Frame 10 will be the opposite extreme of where it is on frames 1 and 20. Now, how did I do?
You got me confused the first time because you said 1 and 10 are the same.
Yeah, I caught myself. I meant to say, every time I said that, I should have said frames 1 and 20 are identical. The position of the camel in frame 1 will be identical to the position of the camel in frame 20. And that kind of makes sense because it loops, it won't jump. it'll just go from where it is in frame one, do its walk, and then when it returns back to the position it was in frame 20, it will be identical to where it was in frame one. So, anyways. Now, what I'd like you to do, can you describe it to me now? Let's see how well I did. Because what I want to do is let you work with it. But I first want to make sure how well I did in describing you. What do you think? Go ahead and tell me what
the right outer is supposed to be forward, and the left outer is supposed to be back.
And right.
Then the right is supposed to be back, but the inner left is supposed to be forward. And frames 1 and 20 are supposed to be the same, and 10 is the opposite.
That's right.
Yeah, I wrote everything down. I want to make sure.
Good. I'm thinking, whoa, you get it. All right, go ahead and play with that for a while, and let me see. Let's turn over to Joshua, because Joshua said that he has he says he's got his figured out.
Okay.
Go ahead, Josh. You can share your screen now.
Okay, it took a little playing, but what I managed to do was I had gone over to my audio file, and at first I figured, okay, maybe before I mess with the audio file, I'll try and put, you know, stop or click here to stop. That still didn't work. I even made that a button and that didn't work. So I played around some more, and I figured I clicked on the audio file. And I said, create a classic tween. And this is what popped up. And I said, okay, well, I'll just try sync. I did the same with the other one. And it come down here and it says repeat. It's okay, I'll say 0. And this is what I got when I exported it.
This is gonna be interesting.
Here we go. Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring might come.
Sounds like there's a fade.
Yeah. Huh?
Hey, that seemed to work.
Yeah, and it took me a little bit to play around because I deleted something and then would go back to what it was doing before. So I had to go back in Command Z and just kind of carefully retraced my steps.
Yeah, I think it might, you might even not need the classic tween. It might just be the sync, the event.
I even deleted the action script except for the one that you showed us the other day.
Yeah. Good. Okay, and you are you in your Canvas space? That's perfect.
And I'm on the Canvas, yeah.
Excellent. Good job. I like it.
I'll make sure I turn that one. I'll turn that one in.
Yeah, hurry up, save it, and export it, and submit it.
Already done. And
good job, Josh.
Good help earlier.
Good find. Okay. Now, very good, Chris. So, Liz is working. Chris, that was Josh. Very good, Josh. Chris is doing all right. Lydell and Stephanie are next. I think Stephanie's next. Stephanie, how can we help you? And Brandon, to answer your question, I'm going to be on until I've helped everybody.
Hello. I'll see you guys later. I'm going to take off.
All right, Josh. Take care, man.
Good night, everybody.
Good job.
Can we say hello to you?
Hi, Stephanie.
Hi.
Do you want to share your screen?
No, but I will. Okay, my problem comes because I have two files that I created in here.
Yeah, one of them is ActionScript based, and the other one's HTML5 based.
So should I just do it over because this was supposed to have been the beginning, the introduction that was supposed to come in, but I didn't know how to convert it into this one.
All right, let's do this. Did you start it over, right?
Yes.
Okay. So with this one, you start over. You start with an ActionScript one, and now let's see what you want to do is if you want that introduction thing, what you need to do is move your move everything, select everything, and then move it to the right, which means you kind of like move the whole animation to the right. Now, there's another thing that I didn't go into and share with other people or share with the students, but there's actually a thing called a scene, and you can create other scenes if you want. We can experiment with that right now, because that the way I taught everybody to do their animation is I had them move it. Week two, we created one. Then week three, we moved that one over, making room for a introduction of 3 seconds. And then we appended after at the end of the animation another 3 seconds for the finale. Now, that's one way of doing that. Another way of doing that same thing, it's just a little bit more involved, a little more complex, is by the use of scenes. Now, let's go up to the very top and click on Insert. A scene. Insert down to the very bottom, scene. Okay. Now, hold on 1 second. Properties. This is now scene two. See the upper left where it says scene two? Click that left arrow next to the scene two, right there. Click it. Is it clickable? Can you click it?
No.
All right. Let's see here. Scene two. Is there a drop down for scene one, scene two? Upper left where it says scene two, click on that area right where it says scene two. Just click there and click, and let's see, just go ahead and click right there. Bang.
Nothing's
coming up for us to go to the scene one. Okay, scene one. Oh, try over to the far right, that little that thing right there. Click that. There we go. Okay. There we go. Okay. So this is scene one. All right. And then click that thing again. And got scene two. And so what we need to do is organize these so that this becomes your first scene and the other one becomes your second scene. But I think what we might have to do is click and select everything in your scene one and copy it and paste it in scene two. But let me, that's where I'm headed. See, do you see what I'm doing? Originally, we had everybody move it over in the timeline. But now I'm introducing this little bit more advanced concept of using scenes. And by doing a scene one, we could do scene one where it would be the splash screen, the introductory thing. And then scene two would be your animation. And then scene three would be the last 3 seconds. So I'm doing it slightly different right now just to experiment with it. And everybody's kind of used to what I was trying to do before. Do you follow what I'm doing, generally speaking?
Yes, I do.
Okay, good. All right. Now, what I have to do is do a little bit of clicking to figure out whether we can just rearrange scenes. Because right now, the content, where is that content that you had that you wanted as part of your introductory thing?
Nope, wrong one.
Is it the part two over there?
Oh, where'd it go?
Yes.
Okay. So I think what you can do is I think you can select everything down there in the layers. Select over, see if you can select both. Do a shift click on layer two, and now do shift click on layer one. And see if you can, okay. Now do a command C, or you can click edit and copy. Just do a command C. Did you do a command C?
Yes.
Okay, now click on the car moving part one FLA tab up there. Click there. And now come down here and click on the timeline and then can you change your cursor to select upper right there? Okay, and then come down here, click on that layer one. And now, just layer one right there. And now do a command V or edit paste. And let me see if we can drop that stuff right into here. What did we do? It pasted. See, that's a different project file. And I'm wondering if the clipboard is. This is the clipboard from this project file. Can you do a command Z? Command Z to undo that paste. What I'm trying to do is see how much we can copy and paste from that other project file. Go back to part two if you would. And then go down and select layers two and one. And now, go ahead and do that again. Click and then shift click on the layer one. And now this time, go up to edit and do cut. All right. Now did we really cut it? Do edit paste right here. Stay in the same one. Edit, paste in place, I think. Which one did you do? Paste in place or paste in center?
Paste in center. Should I undo it?
Yeah. Is that the same way?
Yes.
Okay. So let's see. We successfully cut and pasted. All right. Now we know that it's in the paste buffer. Let's go over to your other file. And now... do another command V, just edit, edit paste. Let me see if that helped us do anything. Click edit. You did a command V?
Yes, command V.
Okay. And so we did successfully get it over here. I guess the background is, you can change, set the background.
Yeah, I can do that.
So anyway, so this is scene two. Now what I want to do is figure out if we can change the order of scenes. All right. Well, in order to do that, I just need to see if it's possible. Let's see. Change order of scenes. Scenes in Flash. How do you rearrange scenes? 8 steps. It's nice to have. Choose window, other panel scene, or press shift F2 to open the scene palette, then drag the names here. Okay, that looks good. Choose window, other panels scene, or press shift F2. So do shift, hold on, let's see, I gotta come back to your screen. Okay, do shift F2 right now. Let's see if that brings up a scenes panel. Did you do that? Shift F2? Did that not help?
Nope, nothing happened.
All right, go up to window, upper right there, window. And then, let's see, scene, there it is. Go down to the very, almost to the very bottom, right up right there. Click scene. Okay, now drag the scene to and drag it above. See if you can click and drag. Let go, great. All right, now what I want you to do is rename scene two to be something like introduction. Double click. Let's see if that lets you rename. Introduction. Oh, let me help you. I'm going to help you. Is that okay?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right. Don't be offended. INT.
I'm not. Okay,
good. Good. All right. INTRO. I didn't mean to put you on the spot.
Are you okay?
Okay, good. D-U-C-T-I-O-N. Awesome. That's a tough word. So now click on scene one, and let's rename that one. Double click. And now capital A, we're going to do animation. Capital A-N-I-M-A-T-I-O-N. Okay. Now click the lower left. Lower left, there's a little thing that's new scene. Lower left or over there, a little right down, right there. Click that. Okay, double click on that. We'll call it ending. Awesome. All right. Now you can actually exit out of this little panel. You might even be able to drag it and put it somewhere, but we're good. Okay. Now, click on that thing up there, that little... yeah, click that. Now, this is how you can go between scenes, okay? Now, let's go over to your go to the introduction. I think probably there, but that's okay, good. Now, what I want you to do, now, how long does this have to be?
I think I was making it about 15.
All right, what's the requirement for the introduction? It needs to be X number of seconds. How many seconds would that be?
3.
That's right, 3 seconds, good. Now, if this animation's clipping along at 24 frames each second, how many total frames does this animation, does this layer need to be in, does this need to show?
10.
Okay, let me do that again.
Okay.
How many total seconds do we have to do?
We have to do 3.
3, okay. Now, if, let's do this. If I had a card deck and I wanted to, have my card deck take 3 seconds for you to watch it, it's going to be one of those flip books, you know, I'm going to spin through the cards. You're going to watch it and it'll be over in 3 seconds, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, if the rate that I'm going to flip cards in front of you, I'm going to flip cards in front of you at the rate of 24 cards every second. How many total cards does my flip book need to be? My flip cards. How many total cards? If I'm going to show you one, it's going to last 3 seconds long, and every second I'm going to flip through 24 of those cards. How many total cards do I need in my stack? And you don't need to do the math. You can just tell me what the math ought to be. Do you know? Does that help?
Not really.
Okay, no worries. Okay, let me. I want you to understand this. So, have you ever seen cartoons before?
Yes.
Okay. Did you know that in order to make a cartoon, every second, do you know how many drawings they need to make? Do you have any idea?
No.
They need to make 24 different drawings for every second of a cartoon that you watch. 4 different drawings for every second. Do you know why they need to make 24 different drawings?
No.
Because in order to show the motion of every cartoon character, it needs to they need to do 24 pictures in order to animate 1 second of the cartoon. Now, the reason why they have to do 24 is because it wouldn't be smooth if they just did one. Because if they only did one painting every second, then it would look really jerky. But if I give you 24 paintings to show every second, it's going to be very smooth. It's going to look realistic. So, every second, how many different paintings do you have to draw in order to show the cartoon character make his movement? How many?
24.
That's right. Now, if I assigned you to make a cartoon that was 3 seconds long, how many total paintings would you have to create?
Okay, how long was it again?
3 seconds long. The cartoon that I assigned you to make is 3 seconds long. And you need to create 24 different drawings. In other words, it's almost like you're doing a video in slow motion, but we're going to slow it down so that if it's going to take you 24 different drawings to just animate 1 second of the cartoon, and I say you've got to do 3 seconds, how many total drawings are you going to be making? Do you have any idea?
75.
Very good. Excellent. That's exactly right. You're off by 3, but that's close enough. 3 times 24. That's perfect, Stephanie. Good job. That's exactly right. Now, every drawing that you make is comparable to every frame in your timeline. So, if we have down there in your timeline, see where the number 1 is?
Uh-huh.
And then we do 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In one second, remember how many drawings you have to make in 24? How many drawings you have to make every second?
3.
Every
no, 24, 25, I'm sorry.
Very good. You got it. You're right. You corrected yourself. That's perfect. You're going to have to do 24 drawings. And so that would be like 24 frames. So click on your timeline where you'll be after 1 second. Show me where on your timeline. That's right. Perfect. Now, after 2 seconds, where will you be? That's right. 2 times 24. Very good. And then after 3 seconds, you know where you'll be. Over there, 72. Very good. 3 times 24. Okay, so this thing, we have to look at this introduction for 3 seconds. So how you need to make it sit there for 3 seconds, or we can do some animation too. But so this thing's got to be 72 frames long or 72 long. So click on the 72 frame there and click on insert and click a keyframe. Okay, good. Now let's just play this. Go to the very beginning by on the lower left. You can click that down right, over the left right there. Left. Yeah, there we go. Good. You got it. You'd already done it. Okay, good. Now click play. And that's going to sit there for 3 seconds. Perfect. Now, let's see. What I want you to do is I want you to run your full animation. Now we're going to use all 3 scenes. So go ahead and click on Control. And we're going to see this show up as scene 1. In other words, introduction. And then after that, it'll be the first 3 seconds. So click on Control, up the upper thing. Control and do, yeah, we'll do test movie. Test, that's good. Let's watch. 1001, 1002, 1003.
1001, 1002, 1003. Before, I don't know how long that one is. And now it just looped. Okay. All right, that's good. You can exit out of that. Okay, so tell me what you just accomplished doing.
Okay, I'm going to stop it. Okay, how do you stop it?
You have to minimize flash and close the other window.
Which one? This one?
Well, just the whole flash program.
Yes, the whole flash window, the dot in the middle here.
No, oh.
No, no, not quit. Cancel. No.
Did I do?
Cancel.
I think we lost it.
The yellow button.
Upper left.
Upper left, the yellow button. I think by closing that, she closed the other one as well.
Yeah. Okay, where's the flash
button? Open the recent.
Huh?
It closed, I think. All right.
I hope she saved that.
I think I did. No.
Well, this is going to be a good experience for you to bring it back. Okay, hold on 1 second. Why don't you stop sharing your screen, and we'll help you here in a second.
No, I didn't save it. Oh, sugars. I didn't save it.
It's okay.
I was just working on it.
Welcome to the world of technology and saving. Okay. Why don't you, let's see what we can do to help somebody else, and then we'll come back.
Okay.
All right.
If I am the last person, you can continue to help her. I'm just here getting ideas
okay.
for my project.
All right. Sounds good.
What I'm doing is a frame by frame with a face. Probably going to have the face singing.
Hey, Lydell, would you mind sharing your screen so other people can see?
Sure.
I know Brandon's here, and he's probably sitting and watching for some ideas too.
Okay, what I'm doing is, and it's not shifting. There you go. I started from a skeleton of a head that I drew.
Uh-huh.
And then I did the outline here. Now I'm working on the eyes, which I have here. I'll stick them all on. Oops. And what that does is I can put the eyes here. Let me make this a little closer. I can arrange the eyes on the face. And like, let's say the next frame, I need the eyes to be open a little bit. I will take, that's full. Okay, I will put these here. And what I have to do is I have to create every part of the eye. I have to do the eyelids, which I should have named those eyelids instead of eyes. And then I have to do the eyeballs with the pupils.
Sure.
The different eyebrows. And I just restarted from yesterday because the first file got corrupted.
Wow.
So...
Are you using onion skinning to...
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I have to do some mouths. I will show you how I did that. Go back to my little outline. And because the teeth don't move, the upper teeth, I mean, you have to make sure that your upper lip continues around this arc, because if you like move the mouth up and down, it won't look right at all.
Mm-hmm.
So what I do to start the mouth, I do this, and then a, trying to get more used to my little pin here.
Is that a Wacom?
Yes, it is. And then a little like this, and for whatever light might reflect. And then I go to I hit function in F8 to make a new keyframe on that on this layer. Hold on, it didn't make one. Function F8. Ooh, yeah, that's a symbol. I have to make this into a symbol. Function F8. Make that mouth. Push period. Function F7. Then I turn on my onion skin. And I need that to be open just slightly. And the lip would come down just a tad bit. And then I would make this a symbol with function F8. If it will, I have to select the keyframe. Then period in function F7. And that, so on and so forth.
Excellent. This is cool. I got to tell you.
I can get it all the way over open. I'll make it all the way to an open O, and then I'll do the L sounds, the vowel sounds, and then like the F's and, you know, things like that. The F would be, I'll have to bring that up this way. Show the teeth here. Because this line is the line where your teeth are.
Mm-hmm.
And then little curls like this. To show that, like the lip is inside the mouth. And then the bottom of the lip would kind of like disappear, because if you're saying a hard F, you know, the outer edge of your lip is in your mouth.
Oh, yeah.
And it's being held by your teeth. So, this would be like an F. I have to make that a symbol. So, like that in F8. I'll try F. And then I have a program over here called Keyframe Caddy that I haven't been able to figure out yet, so I'm not using it. And it's supposed to be able to, is when I'm doing my animation, it's supposed to make it easier. But they're all in the library here. Bless you. So basically, if I want to make So basically, if I'm trying to do an animation where someone's about to talk,
mm-hmm.
and they haven't began talking yet, I would, let me change this name. I take my closed mouth because they haven't begun speaking yet. There I am again. And place the center line over the teeth and they haven't began, and as they start, I'll go to another keyframe where there's nothing. And it's not allowing me to select. Okay, I'll take that keyframe. And I'll take this one out and place in. I guess he likes what he hears now, and he is smiling slightly. But, you know, like I said, it's a tedious thing, and it takes quite a while to get it done.
Oh, yeah, definitely. What is the end goal? To just say one letter, or?
No, I was going to have him singing a song.
What song are you thinking?
I don't know. It wasn't going to be an entire song. It's just like one quick little verse.
Uh-huh.
So that's what I'm doing. It'll probably take me about 3 or 4 days to do it.
Wow.
You know, it says, you know, it should take 4 hours to do the project. So I'm going to take 4 days.
Now, okay. I was going to say, just curious to know if you started over, which is fine. And so I'm just glad that you're taking on the project that you are. It's definitely going to be gorgeous when it's done. Very.
Well, I'll do my best. And also what I might do for all of this, I'm probably going to delete all the mouth symbols, and this portion of the face will be, and it's locked, isn't it? Yes, it is. This portion of the face will be taken out because I would want the mouth and chin to be all one symbol. So while the character's talking, Chris, the door, please. While the character's talking, the chin can move as well. So that's just my plan.
Okay. That sounds interesting. So I'd like to check in with you. I'm going to tell everybody we're going to meet each night at 6 o'clock.
Okay.
And so we've run over, but does anybody want to do anything? Thank you very much, Lydell. I'm really inspired by your creativity.
No problem. I'll do my best.
It's wonderful. It's very inspiring.
I'm trying to get it to where I can take off the screen sharing.
Yeah. Let me see if I can do that for you.
There you go.
All right. So, I'd like to call it a night, everybody. My goal is just to do it for an hour, but, is there anybody, we can do that, Brandon, you bet. Let's go ahead and have you share your screen.
Want me to help with that one?
Is that Chris?
Yeah.
You bet. I think he's got a regular action script file.
Yeah, he told me.
I took a look at it, and it brought this up, and I have no clue exactly what I was supposed to be doing.
Yeah, back up. Scroll. Scroll the little sidebar all the way down. And okay, mine hitting the minus magnifying glass. It's not showing an end.
click around 106, that number. No. See, the sounds are, the sound, the little thing for the fade in is coming up, but.
See you later, Liz.
Not the.
Take stoppers. Care.
There shouldn't be a fade in. There should be a fade out.
Yeah, this is, oh, my bad. Fade out. I got it wrong. But there should be stoppers there. One sec.
You've zoomed out as far as you can, right? There you go. Now grab that little thing between the two tracks and go left.
Yeah, there it is.
See, when do you want, what frame number do you want to quit on? Let's see here.
395.
Okay, so what are these numbers here? 150, 200, I don't even know what the units are.
I don't either.
If I'm not mistaken, the units are in frames, but it's like in its own, like in the amount of time it will take to stop. Beside the little clock, there are frames. There we go. Please ignore the thunderstorms in the background.
Thunderstorms are cool.
Yeah, my little brother's just got scared.
Where are you?
I'm in North Carolina. Yeah, we are having a pretty bad thunderstorm, so.
There you go. I think you got it.
Just hit okay?
Yeah, hit okay and mm-hmm. Save it.
You mind trying to scrub? I mean, not scrub, but test it.
Is your audio playing?
Yes. You can't hear it?
Uh-oh.
No.
See, you probably didn't share. When you did your share, you probably did it without audio. Which is
It stopped and started looping.
Okay. Now let's exit out of this and let's go do the action script to stop.
Hang on. I had the same problem before, though, because it stopped when it looped. But when I did unloop, the song kept going. No, the song just ended now, and the video is still going.
Okay, exit out of this. And wait a minute, stop 1 second. Okay, scene layer one, the error there. Access of unidentified property movie clip. Okay, let's go to your timeline. Let's see. And let's go to the actions layer.
I think it's this one, because that's when it started popping up.
All right, go ahead and delete that.
Actions.
That's probably the other one.
Then it's this one. That's the one we did yesterday with the action script on it.
All right. Go ahead and click F9 to bring up your actions window.
Wait, I thought we were only supposed to have one action.
Okay, click on actions. Yeah, we were experimenting last night. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead and delete everything from line 9 all the way down.
Brian, I am.
Okay, good. Save that and run that.
Okay.
What do we got going on in action 2 layer? I don't remember.
That's something I was doing. It's what I was doing with this thing right here that Josh did. I was trying that out.
Okay, so. Now, what we did, can we get rid of action 2?
I reckon so.
Because I think what we did is you went out right on the layer that had the audio track, right, a second ago?
Yeah.
All right, let's go ahead and save this, I guess, and run it, test it. If you want, you can just run the scene, or you can do it like this. See, we can't hear it because you didn't share it with audio, but that's okay. That looks great.
And it stopped right before it ended. So
okay, so either you can go
add a frame or something to the music, or leave it like it is.
Yeah, sounds good. Like you can add. Well, yeah, you can leave it that way. Yeah, you can also go back and add it.
Yeah, I think you can do a fade out too. Let's go back.
That's what I was trying to do earlier, but that that's just where the music stopped.
Go to the audio track there. Click on that layer of the audio track, and then start, stop.
Oh, no. You want that to stay as an event. The pencil.
Click on effect just for a second. Just above. What's the drop down? Can't hear anybody. Brandon, can you hear me? Christopher, say something.
I'm still here. Can you hear me?
I can hear you fine. I can't hear Brandon anymore.
He got clocked out.
He got logged out. Okay. I gotta call it a night here, guys. Stephanie,
were you able to get what you needed done?
Who, me?
Oh, no, Steph.
Oh, okay. Yeah, Stephanie was working on hers. I need to, end the meeting so I can upload it.
I'm working on it again.
Okay, good.
Yes.
Doing that with the scene is a little bit different.
I was also going to try to tell you guys that you can directly copy the layers, and instead of pasting the layers by frame, if you right-click on the layers you're pasting them in the scene that you're pasting them at, you can paste the layer itself and all of the tweens and frames on it.
Yeah, that's what we did. We actually grabbed two layers for Stephanie. Anyways, I gotta leave. I gotta help my son. So, thanks, you guys. We'll see you tomorrow night at 6 o'clock. Stephanie, do what you can.
Thank you.
All right. Years. See ya.
Okay, I will. Thank y'all. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Night.